Hi students, today our topic is acceleration. Okay, so if the body moving, that means it having velocity. If that velocity changes with respect to time, that means that body moving with the acceleration. Understood? Body is in motion. Okay, its velocity changing with respect to time, that means body moves with the acceleration. Okay, so acceleration is defined as the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. Okay, is called acceleration. Understood? Acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time, dv by dt. Okay, now it is a vector quantity. It is a vector quantity. Now its direction is along the change in velocity direction. Okay, is along the change in velocity. Now units, SI unit, meter per second square acceleration. Okay, CGS unit, centimeter per second square. Dimensional formula, L by T square, simply L T power of minus 2. Understood? Here acceleration is defined as the rate of change of velocity is called acceleration. So on simplification, here formula A equal to dv by dt. It is a vector quantity. Its direction is along the change in velocity. Units, S unit, meter per second square. CGS unit, centimeter per second square. Dimensional formula, L T power of minus 2. Next, average acceleration generally defined as the ratio of change in velocity over a time interval to the time interval. Okay, see, average acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time. Okay, now your change in velocity is right as v2 minus v1 by time, t2 minus t1. Understood? So average acceleration is equal to change in velocity by time. Now here, at the time t1, velocity is v1. At the time t2, velocity is v2. At the time t1, velocity is v1. At the time t2, velocity is v2. Okay. Now here, change in velocity means not only in magnitude. Okay. Sometimes in magnitude, sometimes in a direction, sometimes in both. Okay. Variation in velocity. Variation in velocity. That means here change in magnitude or change in direction change in magnitude or change in direction or change in both. First of all, change in magnitude means if one vehicle moves along a straight line path, okay, direction is fixed here. Direction is fixed. Its speed is increases. Speed along the straight line in forward direction. Speed is nothing but magnitude of the velocity. Magnitude of the velocity. Okay. Here speed is increases. Example of first one. Change in direction means if one body rotate in a horizontal circular path. Rotate in a horizontal circular path means here direction change, speed is constant. Okay. Uniform horizontal circular motion. Okay. Uniform horizontal circular motion. Uniform horizontal circular motion means here speed is constant, magnitude is constant, but direction changes. Okay. Now it is the second example, third example for both are changes means in vertical circular motion. See here velocity v1 bar, here velocity v2 bar, here velocity v3 bar, here velocity v4 bar. Direction changes, at the same time magnitude is also changes. Understood? Okay. Now acceleration sometimes positive, sometimes negative, sometimes zero. Okay. Now acceleration. Acceleration sometimes positive, sometimes negative, sometimes zero. So positive in the sense speed is increases. Okay, speed is increases. Understood? Positive in the sense magnitude is increases. Here magnitude in the sense speed. Understood? In straight line motion. Speed is increased. In this case, acceleration and velocity both are in same direction. Now here, negative in the sense, speed is decreases. So, in this case, acceleration and velocity both are in opposite direction. Zero means uniform motion. That means it is particle moves with constant velocity. Constant velocity means what about change in velocity? Zero. Change in velocity zero means acceleration is also zero. Understood? Okay. Next, instantaneous acceleration. Instantaneous acceleration means acceleration of a particle at particular instant of time. Okay. A instantaneous is equal to, so limit delta t tends to 0, delta v by delta t is equal to dv by dt. Understood? Instantaneous acceleration. Okay. Next, retardation is nothing but negative acceleration is called retardation or deceleration. okay, retardation or deceleration is nothing but negative acceleration of the particle is called as retardation. Negative acceleration of the particle is called as retardation. Understood? Okay. So in this case, speed, that means velocity direction and acceleration direction, both are in a opposite direction. Both are in a opposite direction. Retardation in the sense negative acceleration. Speed is decreases. So velocity and its acceleration both are opposite in direction. Next, uniform acceleration. Uniform acceleration in the sense, here particle has equal changes in velocity. Equal changes in velocity in equal intervals of time. Particle has equal changes in velocities in equal intervals of time. Understood? Okay. That is uniform acceleration. Understood? Okay. So next one, kinematical equations of motion of a particle moving along a straight line with uniform acceleration. Okay. These kinematical equations are very useful in straight line motion to solve the problems. Okay. See here, x of xi means particle initial position, x of xf particle final position, u initial velocity, v final velocity. What is a uniform acceleration? So here, first of all, velocity as a function of time, velocity, final velocity as a function of time, okay, or velocity of a particle at particular instant of time. So that is v is equal to u plus at. Okay. Next, displacement as a function of time. Displacement of a particle at any instant of time or as a function of time is equal to, you know, displacement means final position minus initial position. Final position minus initial position. So simply write as ut plus of at square. So s is equal to ut plus of at square. Next one, position as a function of time. Final position is equal to initial position plus ut plus of at square. Here required one is position. Here required one is displacement. Understood? Next, velocity as a function of displacement. So velocity as a function of displacement is v square minus u square is equal to 2s. Displacement in nth second of motion. Okay, in nth second of motion, Sn equal to u plus a by 2 into 2n minus 1. Understood? Next, so displacement is equal to, you write as displacement is equal to average velocity into time. Okay, what is the average velocity here? U plus v by 2 into t. Displacement is also right as average velocity into time. Understood? Okay, it is the displacement u plus v by 2 average velocity into time. Understood? Okay. Note this one once. See one problem. The displacement x of a particle at the instant when its velocity v is given by v equal to square root of 3x plus 16. find its initial velocity and acceleration. Okay, first of all, take a given equation, v is equal to square root of 3x plus 16. Squaring on both side, v square is equal to 3x plus 16. Okay, v square minus 16 is equal to 3x. Now it write as v square minus 16 is write as 4 square 2 into 1.5 into x. Understood? Now this equation is write as v square minus 4 square equal to 2, 1.5 into x. See, this equation compared with v square minus u square is equal to 2a, yes. Here x represents the displacement. 1.5 is nothing but acceleration. 4 is nothing but initial velocity. Now here, initial velocity is equal to, initial velocity u is equal to 4 meter per second. Okay. Simply units are not given, 4 units. And acceleration a is equal to 1.5 units. Acceleration is 1.5 units. See, this equation is modified in the form of v square minus u square equal to 2s, and also compared to this one. So initial velocity is equal to 4 units. Acceleration is 1.5 units. Understood? Okay. Now, small application. One body, initial velocity is u, final velocity is v, it moves with a constant acceleration. Here required one is midpoint velocity. Understood? So midpoint means its distance is s, mean displacement is s, means this displacement is also s. Understood? Now taking this one, see, vm square minus u square is equal to 2s. First off, in second off, final velocity is v square. For this one, initial velocity is middle is equal to 2as. Once again, here for this part, final velocity is v sub xm, initial velocity u. You know formula, v square minus u square equal to 2s. Based on that one, it is one of the equation. For second part, initial velocity is v sub xm, final velocity is v, because of uniform acceleration. Exactly midpoint means this displacement s, means this displacement is also s. So based on v square minus u square equal to 2s formula, this one. Now these two equations are same. It is 2s, this one is also 2s. Equating these two, vm square minus u square equal to v square minus vm square. V square minus vm square. It is taking this side. Vm square plus vm square equal to v square plus u square. V square plus u square. This one, 2 vm square equal to v square plus u square. Vm square equal to v square plus u square by 2. Square taking this side. Vm is equal to v square plus u square by 2. Midpoint velocity is equal to here, square root of v square plus u square by 2. Okay, one body moving with uniform acceleration, initial velocity is u, final velocity v. What is the midpoint velocity? Midpoint velocity is equal to square root of v square plus u square by 2. Okay.